I dreamed about this pass for 2 weeks, in the last corner and in the last lap.
Say the truth, I didn't expect him to pass me. He was more clever or more brave.
Valentino, that last overtake, have you actually seen anybody else make an overtake at that corner?
Actually, he did it to me in 2007.
Thank you, Casey. That's what I wanted to know.
I learned my lesson already.
This was before Lorenzo was in MotoGP. 6 laps to go. Rossi passes Stoner in the final corner. Stoner went on to win the race, but Rossi played that card. He knew he could do it.
It's unbelievable, I think. Never happened before. After 6 races, we are equal point, but not 2 riders, 3 riders.
3 riders on the same points after 6 races. Suddenly, one of them is in big trouble.
After just a few laps, I was completely destroyed. I was very close to pulling in the pits, and the bike was working really well, but I just wasn't able to keep the pace. I couldn't brake, you know, I was nearly falling in the front of the bike under brakes. You know, my legs cramping, everything, my stomach.
Heat stroke? A virus? Stoner looks terrible after the race. It's a shame. He was the fastest guy out there today. Set the fastest lap on lap 2. It could have been a 3-way fight. Danny Pedrosa is also walking wounded. He fractured his femur when he crashed in the Mugello race. Then he re-injured his hip when he fell in qualifying in Barcelona.
Unfortunately, it was on the right side. Again, one more shock on this area. This kind of injury needs time. Everybody knows we don't have.
Catalunya was Valentino Rossi's 99th Grand Prix victory. Can he make it 100 at the oldest circuit on the calendar? Assen is another of the world champion's favorite tracks. He's won here 7 times.
This is a special place for sure. Assen is the place with more history behind. Also, my father won here with 250.
Pedrosa and Stoner both have fitness problems. Lorenzo is the threat.
Another battle with Jorge, like in Barcelona, is too much, especially for the old people like my grandmother. I make a good start from the pole position. I try to push a lot because I know Jorge have more or less my same pace.
Pedrosa and Stoner are ahead of you. Lorenzo's behind. You need to get away. Pass Pedrosa and Stoner and keep pushing.
Thank you.
It's not like Catalunya. Third on the grid, sixth at the first corner. What's happening? You've got the speed to challenge Rossi, but now you've got four other riders ahead of you. Get past them in the next five laps and go after him. Give it everything.
Thank you.
Pedrosa crashed out of the race. He's okay. No more damage. Casey Stoner is not okay. He finished third, then went straight to the medical center. But one man is having a great time.
Arriving to 100 is for sure something special, also because I'm just the second rider in all the history, together with Agostini, to achieve this result. He have 22 races more, so he's the greatest.
Rossi's fan club has brought a celebration banner from Italy, a very long celebration banner showing all his wins.
Flavio called me and say, please try to win in Assen because it's so long, so it's not possible bring goals in Laguna or in other part.
The next race is on the other side of the world, in California.
I feel good and I feel fast on the bike. We hope to win some other races.
Tight, twisty, difficult. Laguna Seca hasn't been kind to Jorge Lorenzo. He crashed out on the first lap in 2008, his first race here. This year he's on pole, but he can barely walk after qualifying.
At this moment I have a lot of pain in my foot and also in my right shoulder, but I will try, you know. You have to try.
Qualifying was almost over. Lorenzo was fastest, but he wanted more. He needed a clear track. He slowed down to let the riders ahead of him go. In those moments, his tires cooled slightly. As the heat in the rubber decreased, so did the grip. It was the same story at a different corner for Casey Stoner.
I got held up on my lap, similar to Jorge, and my tires weren't heated up enough. Basically, as I went into that corner, it was a long entry, so I thought, you know, I had a plenty of feeling all the way into the middle of the corner. I hadn't even got on the gas yet, and the back came round, and that was it, game over. I got away with it, very lucky. You know, it hurt a heck of a lot at the time. I just got a bit of a problem in my shoulder and my groin, but we'll give it a heck of a try tomorrow.
Of the fastest four, Rossi's the only one who's feeling fine. Danny Pedrosa comes to California from a rough weekend in Holland. Last year, he missed the race here through injury, and he's riding injured again today. Tough times. But like they say, when the going gets tough. Rossi's coming. He's faster than you. He's gonna catch you. But you're in front. Can you stay there?